Wonderful greetings to all of you, my dearly beloved brothers and sisters. How are you all today? It's so good, so lovely and joyful to meet all of you once again today. I hope our good Lord has been taking good care of you all throughout these last 24 hours. So come, join with us for another lively discussion on a topic that we began yesterday about respect for elders, respect in the family, respect for society, and how are the different changes that are taking place. And we left at what is happening in the secular society has a spillover effect in the church. And Pastor G,
yes,
that's where we left off yesterday. That the spillover effect is troubling the church or affecting the church, and you are going to explain how this is affecting the church.
Well, we see in the church of the day today that the people that go to the church, they don't have any more respect for the pastors or the leaders anymore. Mm. You know, they have brought themselves to the same level.
Mm.
So when you see people bringing forth the word or correction or helping, mm. there's a resistance of taking the counsel or help.
Mm.
So
now, let's break up something here.
Uh-huh.
Now, when did you enter into the ministry?
Well, full-time ministry in 1991.
Okay, so about this year that I came to the U.S.
Yes.
So in 1991, and you were a pastoral staff for how many years?
For 9.5 years.
Okay, so during the 9 years of your pastoral ministry in a large church, how did you see this from, say, 91 up to the year 2000?
You know, I would have to say that it increased. When I got into the ministry in 1991, it wasn't that bad. There was respect, there was honor. But as we saw the breakup of the biblical standards that were being followed in our workplace, in the circular, I'm talking about in the world atmosphere, as that started to diminish, the fear of the Lord started to diminish from the hearts of the people.
Mm.
And the church became a not a place of gathering, but more of an institution.
Mm.
So as the institutionalization of the church started to happen, and the one man order started to come in, that they were just a pastor and no longer a servant,
mm.
and the other pastors were being trained the same way, and even in the pastoral responsibilities, the pastor started to get away from actually taking care of the sheep.
Oh.
So that created a disrespect in the eyes of the people, who became lawless, if I may say,
mm.
to say, you know, we're not going to listen. So, but there, you know, again, I'm talking about a group. I'm not talking about everybody,
mm.
you know. So I'm concentrating more on a group, small group, which now has become very large,
okay.
over the years.
So you would say that from 91 up to the year 2000, you saw a gradual breakdown,
yes.
of respect for authority,
yes.
in the church,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Now, as you said yesterday on the previous episode, that the changes taking place in society, with there's lawlessness because the Bible is no more there, we don't know the commandments and all that. I was thinking, you know, if you look at the laws in all the lands, or in fact, most of the laws that we have today were largely shaped out of Great Britain.
Yes.
England, you know.
Yeah.
And if you look at the foundational laws of many things, they are all largely based on the Ten Commandments.
Yes.
Except for maybe the first four. honor God, respect God, there is no other God except the four, the rest of the six. As far as it when it comes to ruling society, is the rest six that were been followed, like you should not commit adultery, don't take another man's wife, don't commit murder, don't bear false witness, all that you can find in society now. So now, if God didn't give the Ten Commandments, how would anyone ever know that killing one another is wrong?
That's right.
It is God who put the law there.
Yes.
Killing one another is wrong.
Yeah.
See, like if you knock down a... What is the animal that crosses the road when you're driving?
Deer.
Deer? No, the small ones. Raccoon?
Raccoons.
Raccoons. See, so many raccoons are lying like flat pancake on the road, you know, with all the intestines out. Nobody bothers.
No.
What if you knock down a deer by accident? Are you charged?
Well, you're not charged, but your car is totally
gone.
Okay.
See, you knock down a deer won't die, is it?
No, deer will die.
Okay, a deer dies, a raccoon gets smashed up, nothing.
No.
But if you hit a man, that becomes a chargeable offense.
Yes.
Right?
Right.
Now, where did we get that idea from?
From the Ten Commandments.
From the Ten Commandments.
Yeah.
Thou shalt not kill.
Yeah.
Or thou shalt not injure one another.
Yes.
That came from there.
Yes.
Okay, stealing. Where did we get the idea that if I steal your watch, if I take your watch, that which is not mine, that's called stealing.
Yes.
That's from the Ten Commandments.
Yeah.
Thou shalt not steal.
Mm-hmm.
Which means, what is yours is yours.
Yes.
It's not ours.
Yeah.
Or common property.
Yeah.
I cannot just say, come, hey, look, I need that. I'll just take that.
Yeah.
So that knowledge of the law came from the Ten Commandments.
Yes.
Adultery. Mm-hmm. Wife swapping. You cannot wife swap. Where did we get that idea from?
The Ten Commandments.
The Ten Commandments. Lying. That is also from the Ten Commandments.
Yes.
If not for the Ten Commandments, we don't have all these laws.
Yes.
So now, if you remove the Ten Commandments, what happens? Lawlessness.
Yes.
See, that is another diabolical plan of the devil to create anarchy and lawlessness in the land is by removing the person who instituted all this. So who is that? God. First get rid of him. Get rid of God from the land. How to get rid of God from the land? How is people connecting with God? Prayer and Bible reading.
Yes.
Okay, where is it starting? Starting from the schools. Okay, let's attack the schools first.
Yes.
Let's go. Because that's where the foundational years are being forged. Attack the kids.
Mm-hmm.
It started there, right?
Yes.
Okay, remove, a law was passed. Mm-hmm. Remove Bible reading, remove prayer from the schools because ACLU, they championed the cause that we should be, the church and the state should be separated, not be co-mingling. So largely they were successful, but what was the price? Society broke down.
Broke down, yes.
Family broke down. Churches begin to break up.
Yep.
More
yeah.
than before.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So as a result, that which was holding each other was no more there. You become a law yourself.
That's right.
Right?
Yep. I do whatever I want to do.
I do whatever I want to do. So, since there's no more Bible reading, no more prayer, so there's no more connection between me and God. No connection.
Yes.
If there's no connection, I don't think about God anymore. If I don't think about God, I am God.
Yes.
See how diabolically and stealthily the devil crept in.
Yes.
With such thinking. The I thing came into the American society because God was kicked out.
Yeah.
From the very fabric of the American or Western society. Kicked out.
Mm-hmm.
Out. Oh, because we can think for ourselves now. When you begin to reason, ask questions, No harm asking scientific questions, no? For to develop knowledge. But you don't question, are you really my father? Let's say your son, no? He goes to school, the teacher tells him, you must question everything.
Yeah.
So that your mind can grow. So he comes home, are you really my father?
Yes.
If he asks you a question, mm-hmm. I need to question you. I need to know. I need to know for sure, are you really my father? Or he points a finger at your wife and say, are you really my mother? Mm-hmm. I must know for sure. Because I didn't see with my eyes.
Yes.
I only know. Am I right?
True. Yes, absolutely true.
He said, I only know that you are my mother, because either from the birth certificate or what you are telling me.
Yes.
But how do I know it's true?
My goodness. Yeah, that is so true, Sadhuji.
Pray, thank God it didn't come to that, no?
I know.
Except that, everything else is being questioned.
Yeah.
But this thing takes on a different form by children rebelling against parents.
Yes.
Children questioning parents' authority. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Children challenging parents' authority.
Yes.
And how society, how society at large has also helped to fuel that is when they brought laws like you should not discipline your children.
Yes.
You should not spank your children. You should not correct your children when they, that also first started in the schools.
Yes.
You see? Mm-hmm. And then the same law came into the family. Mm-hmm. If you spank, your own kids have the right to report you.
Yeah. See, Sadhuji, when you were talking about this, mm-hmm. I was just brought to the question we were talking about yesterday. Mm-hmm. When I went to school in India, mm-hmm. I was disciplined more in school than I was disciplined at home. Mm-hmm. I have more spanking that I received in school of disobeying.
Tell me about that.
I remember in one class, I used to hate that class, science class, And, when you tell this to people in America, they said that was abuse. Mm. But I look back after so many years, I said, no, that was character building. Mm. I remember we had in Bombay, where I was going to school, this powder that you put on anybody, they just itch all the time.
Uh-huh.
So I used to not like this science teacher, Mm. So one day I put some of the powder on his desk before the class. Mm. Somehow he found out it was me.
Oh.
So for the next 2 weeks, the period, science period, would be 50 minutes. Mm. I had to kneel down on my knees for that 50 minutes with my hands raised up.
Oh. This lasted for how long?
2 weeks.
2 weeks, okay.
Mm. But today, if we did that in school.
Oh, you will end up in the court.
In the jail.
Yes.
And same way with the parents.
Mm. Yes.
An 8-year-old boy can call the police on 911 and say, my mother just beat me. Mm. They'll take her to the prison.
When I was about 6 or 7, my older sister and I, we got into a little fight. Kids, no?
Yeah.
I can't remember what we fought over, but I just called it a you pick. In a fit of anger. You pick. She went and complained to my father. So my father was a tough disciplinarian, So when he heard what I told her, and my older sister was his pet. First daughter, and she's very cute looking. Oh, my daughter is crying. This boy has called her pick. So he sat on a chair, he made me kneel down, he said, what did you call your sister? I said, I was urinating in my pants, for fearing what is going to come, and how can I dare to say what I have to say? So he keep on, tell me. So finally I said, oh no, pick up. Okay, that's what you told your sister, no? Okay. He brought some green
chilies.
Eat it now. Green chilies with black pepper.
Yeah.
Eat it. said, looking. He has a way of looking, you know. It's one look. It's enough to scare the daylights out of you. So I had it. Tears were rolling down. That day, I forgot what it means. It totally took away from my mind and from my attitude to scold someone as a pig. But if you had applied today's method, son, you should not call your sister a pig because pigs are not so beautiful animals. You cannot sometimes talk sense.
Right.
Because the reasoning capacity is not there.
Yeah.
That is why the scripture says, if you spare the rod, you spoil the child.
That's right.
Doesn't God know what he's talking about?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because the rod has been spared. In the Western society today, look at the rebelliousness among our children.
Yes.
Because the rod has been spared.
Yeah.
No more spankling.
Yeah.
That's violent.
Mm-hmm.
Very bad.
Yeah.
Because it will wound the spirit of a child. But there is a degree of measure of truth to that, wounding the child. Like, for example, when I was growing up, like I said, my father was a tough disciplinarian. He used to spank me with his belt, with a cane, and all that. But I was being spanked and not being told what wrong I did.
Right.
Like, for example, I was out in the playground once playing marbles with my friends, you know. And he was entertaining some friends at our home, and he used to smoke. This is in the 60s.
Yeah.
And he ran out of cigarettes, and he called for me. I was out there.
Mm-hmm.
I stole away from the house because he was busy with his friends.
Yeah.
And my sister told him, oh, he's not around. So he got very upset. Where is he? So she went looking and looking and looking. 10-15 minutes passed by while she was looking. And he was getting fidgety. What?
Anxious.
Anxious because they needed to smoke, you know. More for his friends than for him. So finally she found me in the playground. She said, you are dead. As soon as she saw me, you are dead. You are going to get it. So I came shivering, you know. Said, so he asked me. So in front of his friends, he behaved very diplomatically. Said, where were you? Said, playground. Okay, go and buy a cigarette. Okay, I came. I bought. But that was the end. But the rest of the evening, I was sitting outside, shivering. Thinking what's going to happen as soon as the friends all leave, no? What I feared came to pass, Pastor Ji. As soon as his friends left, he took his belt and he whacked me left and right until there were blue-black marks all over my hands and the skin tore and my mother had to apply medicine. Now, that is not correct.
Right.
Later on, now this happened in 67 or 68, you know. But in 1986, I had a visitation from an angel of the Lord who shared with me how children should be brought up from God's perspective.
Hmm.
He said, parents should discipline their children. The rod must not be spared, but they should not be disciplined out of anger.
Right.
Sometimes a father and mother may have a fight.
Yeah.
Who will they pick on?
Children.
The poor kids.
Yeah.
They will pour out all the anger on the poor kids and they can't punch each other, no?
No.
They can't spank each other, no. They'll spank the kids.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
So that, the angel told me, that is sin.
Hmm.
That is wrong. Should discipline the children because of love and correction rather than out of anger. Then they should be told why they have been punished. Then it will be corrective rather than damaging to their soul.
Mm.
Like I was wounded, you know.
Right.
I began to entertain hurts and bitterness, anger in my heart towards my father. Mm-hmm. So why am I being beaten for no rhyme or reason?
Right.
What did I do wrong?
Right.
He's playing marble wrong.
Yeah.
I was playing when you did not want me.
Right.
You know? So why was that a problem? Even then, I promptly went and bought the cigarettes.
Yeah.
I did not disobey you. So why did you spank me? So that question mark. And all the other incidences, no?
Right.
Why I was being spanked. Then later on, when I began to walk with the Lord, then the Lord began to deal with me. He said, let go of all the hurts and the bitterness that you have against your father. Because as long as you have it, he will not come to me.
Yes.
So that is a different story. But like you say, it is more damaging when we discipline out of anger.
That's right.
But then now we went to the other extreme. Mm-hmm. Totally hiding the rot away.
Oh, yeah.
No more to be seen. Right?
Because the laws changed.
Yes.
That even if you wanted to apply the word of God, it wouldn't work for you. You couldn't go, you know, hit your or discipline your children and go to police and say, it's written in the book of Proverbs, I was only following the word, they'll put you in jail.
Like quite recently. Recently meaning in about a year ago, a very popular minister of God in the US was charged in prison, or charged in the police charged him because, you know the story.
Yes.
His daughter wanted to go late out at night. And she was underage, no? Under legal age.
Yes.
14 or 15.
Right.
Right?
Right.
You know the whole story?
Yeah.
Please,
yeah.
Tell us.
Well, and she couldn't go.
You don't have to name names.
No. She couldn't go. So, because of having anger, bitterness, she accused her father, who ended up having to go to the police station.
So, he did not manhandle her in any way?
Not manhandle, she scolded her.
Okay.
And said, you are not going to go.
Did she kind of get violent with him? And then he pushed her down?
I you know...
Did something like that happen?
It's possible, Sadhguru. Uh-huh. You know, it's possible because you know how it is with the news. You don't know the whole truth. But it is possible, you know. I know children. I've had children. And I can see them nagging. You know, nagging you, coming. Oh, Dad, please let me go. Please let me go. I've done that many times when my girls were growing up. I said, no. And you just push them away. You know, come on, leave me alone. You know, I don't want to deal with this right now. I told you, you're not going. That's it. You know, with that stern voice. It's possible something like that happened and she fell, you know. But the laws have changed so much.
So in her anger, she turned against her father and called 911.
Yes.
And then he was arrested and put in prison.
Yeah.
And that became a sensational news for
all
the
over.
Tabloids and for the media.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
Now, so this is a classic example of what has happened about lawlessness.
Yes.
The breakdown of society, breakdown of family fabric, and breakdown of discipline.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yes.
Now, where is all this leading to? This is what was already prophesied 2,000 years ago by the Apostle Paul. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 1 to 6, said, in the last days, there will be perilous times.
Yes.
The children will become disobedient to parents. So that society, you see, anarchy, lawlessness will break about in society on a large scale. So when this breaks about, you know, the governments of the world, see, when it breaks about in one nation here, one nation there, one nation there, everywhere anarchy breaking out everywhere. People become very lawless and this and that. So they will now begin to enact laws, very tough laws, to deal toughly with people. They will even now begin to view their own citizens as terrorists.
Yes.
Oh, you are like behaving like a terrorist. You are a threat to society. So we have to now enact stricter laws to deal tough with this
disobedience.
Disobedience. Or they will say, no, this is not enough. We have to bring another kind of system. What is that system? This is something we are going to talk about tomorrow. Sorry, Pastorji, to hang this in suspense like that. Sorry, my dear friends and brothers and sisters and partners. Back of time. Okay. But we will meet again tomorrow. Hang on there. Alright. Hang on there. Same time tomorrow, please spread this news to all your dear friends to watch Angel TV on the Glory Star satellite system. We are seeing this ad. News to all your dear friends, call them and tell them and get or call your local cable to get this on their system. All right, God bless you. We'll meet again tomorrow.